And now let's take a look at what happens when Holden makes his first sale. When you sell merchandise, four accounts change in your chart of accounts for every sale of merchandise. Two accounts change by the amount of the price of the sale, and two other accounts change by the amount of the cost of the sale. When we sell merchandise, the amount of the sales price gets recorded into the new account we created, sales, which is an income account telling us the total money that came in from customers for selling merchandise. However, for that very same sale, what we paid for the specific merchandise that we just gave the customer will be recorded into the account called cost of goods sold. This way you can measure the difference between them and know your profit for that one sale. When we originally purchased the merchandise, the purchase cost of the merchandise was recorded in the account called inventory asset. Therefore, when you sell merchandise, the balance of the inventory asset will decrease by the amount of the purchase cost of the goods that were sold. However, since the customer just gave you a check, undeposited funds will increase. And of course, when the customer gives you a check, the money amount is the sales price of the goods that were sold. And those are the two other accounts that will change for this very same sale, and those are the amounts that will change them. Let us imagine on May 20, Holden sold 10 apples to Alan, and Alan gave Holden check number 1212. Well, I happen to know that the price of that sale is equal to $500, and that will be the amount of the sales receipt. But I also happen to know that Holden paid $100 to buy the apples that he just sold to Alan for $500. Holden originally paid $100 for the specific apples that he is now giving to Alan on May 20. Therefore, sales, the income account, will show up for the very first time on the trial balance as $500, and cost of goods sold will show up on the trial balance for the very first time as $100. Now here we are at the trial balance. We do not yet have sales income at 500. We do not yet have cost of goods sold. From the main menu, click Customer, enter sale receipt. The date of the sale was May 20. The customer was Alan Arby. The item was apples. Notice when you choose apples, QuickBooks remembers it was $50 an apple. And the quantity of this sale was 10. Therefore, QuickBooks knows the price of the goods that are sold is $500, but you don't see listed on the invoice that the purchase cost, meaning what we paid, the $100 that we bought the apples from, that we paid when we bought the apples from the vendor, is not listed here. Save and close, and now when we look at the trial balance, for the very first time, sales, the income account, shows up as $500, and cost of goods sold, the account that QuickBooks put on the chart of accounts, shows up for $100, and the difference is our profit from this specific sale. Let's open up the inventory asset and see what it looks like. When we double-click, we can see that the inventory balance went up for these checks, and the inventory balance went down specifically by $100 for this specific sale receipt. If we look at the inventory report, reports, inventory, inventory valuation detail, we will notice something interesting. We notice that the quantity of apples originally went up by the check on May 18th, but the quantity of apples decreased by the from the sale receipt on May 20th. And this here is showing the number of apples in each transaction. This is showing the remaining quantity after the transaction. Holden's next merchandise sale happened on May 21. He sold 7 bananas to Betty. Because he sold on account, he has to make an invoice. The price of this sale that Betty will pay in the future is $700. Holden paid $140 to the vendor to buy the specific bananas that he is now giving to Betty on May 21. From the main menu, click Customers, Create Invoice. Now, May 21, the customer is Betty. The item is bananas. Quantity, notice we can click the quantity box here as a nice feature and see the current quantity on hand of bananas. We close it out. We type in here 7, push tab, and this shows that this invoice is $700. However, we paid, or Holden paid, $140 originally to buy these bananas. Keep that in mind. When we click save and close, the trial balance changes. Now we can see cost of goods sold is now $240. However, sales, the income account, is now $1,200. When we open up the sales account, we can see that this sale receipt put in $500 into the sales account. This invoice where we sold bananas to Betty put another $700 of income into this income account, and that's the reason it became $1,200. When we look at cost of goods sold, we see the two very same sales, but we don't see the sales price of those two. We see the purchase cost. And as I promised, the purchase cost of this invoice was $140. That's why cost of goods sold has a balance of $240. Notice the inventory asset is $560. Some of these are bananas and some of these are apples. When we look at the inventory valuation detail, we will know why the inventory asset is $560. Reports, inventory, inventory valuation detail. Don't forget to push A for all. Now we can see this invoice decreased the quantity of bananas by 7 bananas. Now we only have 23 bananas on hand. And you can see that this invoice also lowered the physical quantity in such a way that the total money we have, well, the quantity on hand for bananas is 23. At $20 each, that means that the value of bananas is now $460. The value of apples, because we now have 10 on hand, is $100. Therefore, the total value of all the inventory together is $560. Apples plus bananas equals $560. And that's what the total is in the inventory asset account, $560.